الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله رب العالمين، والعاقبة للمتقين، والصلاة والسلام على رسوله الكريم وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أما بعد، أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم، من همزه ونفخه ونفثه. قل إن الموت الذي تفرون منه فإنه ملاقيكم، ثم تردون إلى عالم الغيب والشهادة فينبئكم بما كنتم تعملون. My dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, the life that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us, sooner or later this life is going to come to an end. Allahul Jalal Ikram has given us this life for a very short period of time. And we are not here in this dunya to live forever. If Allahul Jalalul Ikram would have allowed anyone to live in this dunya forever, then the prophets and the messengers of Allahul Jalalul Ikram, they were the most eligible or entitled to live in this dunya. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said in explicit words in the Quran, وَمَا جَعَلْنَا لِبَشَرٍ مِنْ قَبْلِكَ الْخُلْدِ. O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we did not allow any bashar, any human being before you to live on this dunya forever. So this is how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created this dunya. And we all know that we are going to leave this dunya. And when our life comes to an end, this is what is called death. Death is a reality that no one can deny. No one can escape from it, regardless of their belief, regardless of their religions, regardless of their ethnicities, regardless of their ideologies. No one can deny the reality and the fact of the death. Even those who do not believe in the existence of Allahul Jalal Ikram, they cannot even deny death. Everyone accepts that this is a reality. Although they believe with regards to the event of the death and also the events that take place after death are completely different. But we as a Muslim, we have been encouraged by Allahul Jalal Ikram and our Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to remember our death all the time. And this is the most important or the biggest or greatest difference between a Muslim and a non-Muslim when it comes to the matter of death. A disbeliever or a non-Muslim, someone who does not believe in Allah or in the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they do not want to focus on death. Rather, they want to forget it and neglect it and ignore it. But as for us Muslims, we have to remember our death and we need to focus on our death. And if you truly focus on your death, the matters of your life, when it comes to practice the religion of Allahul Jalal Ikram, will be completely different. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has told us in the Quran, قُلْ إِنَّ الْمَوْتَ الَّذِي تَفِرُّونَ مِنْ فَإِنَّهُ مُلَاقِيكُمْ. Say, indeed, the death that you are trying to escape from, فَإِنَّهُ مُلَاقِيكُمْ, it is going to overtake you one day. ثُمَّ تُرَدُّونَ إِلَىٰ عَالِمِ الْغَيْبِ وَالشَّهَادَةِ, then you will be returned to the knower of the unseen and the present. فَيُنَبِّئُكُمْ بِمَا كُنْتُمْ تَعْمَلُونَ, and then he will inform you of what you have been doing in this dunya. أَيْنَمَا تَكُونُوا يُدْرِكُمُ الْمَوْتُ وَلَوْ كُنْتُمْ فِي بُرُوجٍ مُشَيَّدَةٍ. Wherever you are, the death is going to overtake you, even if you try to hide yourself inside the lofty, constructed and strong built-up castles. You cannot hide yourself from the death. Death can overtake you. Death is such a reality and certainty that the death itself is certain, but its time is not certain. Its age is not certain. Its place is not certain. Something very strange. Itself, death itself is certain. No one can deny it. No one can escape from death. That is why our Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, أَكْثِرُوا ذِكْرَ هَذِ مِنْ لَذَّاتِ الْمَوْتِ. He advised us sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that we should reflect and we should remember our death every day. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has taught us a dua that we should read before going to sleep. The dua is Allahumma bismika amutu wa ahya. And even our children remember this dua. Have you ever pondered and reflected on the meaning of this dua? When you say Allahumma bismika amut, O Allah, in your name I'm going to die. Because the sleep is very similar to death. When you go to sleep, you cannot hear, you cannot see, you cannot taste, you cannot talk. You lose all the senses. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has taught us this dua so that we can remember our death before going to sleep. And then when we wake up in the next morning, the very first thing we say, Alhamdulillah, Alladhi ahyana ba'dama amatana wa ilayhi nushur. All praise due to Allah al Jalal Ikram, the one who has given us life once again after he caused us to die. So we were dead last night. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us life once again. So every single morning, every single evening, we are encouraged to remember our death. Why? Because the event of the death is very strong and terrifying, and terrifying and frightening event. And especially what takes place straight after death, it is very scary to the level that the Salaf, even the companions, Ridwanullahi alayhim ajma'een, they were more worried about their grave than the paradise and the hellfire. Sayyiduna Uthman ibn Affan radiyallahu ta'ala, an individual who was given the glad tidings of paradise by the blessed tongue of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam on many occasions. Not once or twice, so many times. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in very clear word, Uthmanu fil Jannah, Uthman is in paradise. And once the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, at one occasion when he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked his companions to give in the charity in the way of Allah bil Jalal Ikram, Uthman radiyallahu ta'ala anhu gave such a big amount in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam got very excited and he said, مَا ضَرَّ عُثْمَانَ مَا عَمِلَ بَعْدَ الْيَوْمِ. Nothing is going to harm Uthman after this day, whatever he wants to do. Allah has written for him paradise. And look at the condition of Uthman radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. His servant Hani, he says, I used to see Uthman radiyallahu ta'ala anhu that the paradise and the hellfire would be mentioned in his presence and he would never cry. He would hear the ayat and the ahadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with regards to the hellfire and also the paradise. And he would not cry. But as soon as someone would make the mention of the grave, Uthman radiyallahu ta'ala anhu would start crying and weeping. And once I asked him, why is this, O Uthman? Uthman radiyallahu ta'ala anhu said, لِأَنِّي سَمِعْتُ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ يقول إن القبر أول منازل الآخرة فمن نجا منه فما بعده أيسر وَمَنْ لَمْ يَنْجُ مِنْهُ فَمَا بَعْدَهُ أَشَدْ. Because I heard the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saying that the grave is the very first stage of the stages of the hereafter. It is the very first stage. فَمَنْ نَجَى مِنْهُ فَمَا بَعْدَهُ أَشَدْ. And whoever passes this stage successfully, and whatever is going to happen afterwards is going to be very easy for him. وَمَنْ لَمْ يَنْجُ مِنْهُ فَمَا بَعْدَهُ أَشَدْ. And whoever cannot pass this stage successfully, then the afterwards events are going to be even severe and difficult. That is why Uthman radiallahu ta'ala anhu used to cry when he radiallahu ta'ala anhu would visit the graves. That is why, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, we need to reflect and we need to remember our death and our grave every day. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam advised his beloved companion Abdullah ibn Umar radiyallahu ta'ala anhumah. He said, O Abdullah, kun fi dunya ka annaka ghareeb aw aabiru sabeel. O Abdullah, live in this dunya as if you are a stranger. When you are a stranger, you do not know anything about the area. You do not even try to invest anything. You stay there, you do your job, and then you go back to your home. Because you are a stranger. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Kun fi dunya ka annaka ghareeb aw aabiru sabeel." Or live the life of this dunya as you are crossing a road or you are passing a path. And then he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, عُدَّ نَفْسَكَ مِنْ أَهْلِ الْقُبُورِ. O Abdullah, consider yourself from the people of the graves. Don't consider yourself from the people of this dunya. And Abdullah ibn Umar radiallahu ta'ala, whenever he would narrate this hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he used to say, the meaning and explanation of this hadith is, إِذَا أَصْبَحْتَ فَلَا تَنْتَظِرِ الْمَسَاءِ وَإِذَا أَمْسَيْتَ فَلَا تَنْتَظِرِ الصَّبَاحِ. If you have witnessed a morning in your life, then never wait for the evening. And if you have witnessed an evening in your life, then never wait for next morning. Rather, you should consider yourself to be amongst the people of the graves by the evening and by the morning. So my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, the point is that we need to remember our deaths and we need to remember our graves. Because as I said, the event of the death is very terrifying. And as soon as you are approached by the angels of the death, you will know your end and you will know what is going to happen after. In other words, the whole struggle that we have to make in this dunya is for that one single moment. Because when the angel of death comes, you will know what is going to take place after it. As the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has told us and he has explained us about the event of the death and whatever happens after death. The life in the grave. How people spend their life in their graves. Bara bin Azib radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he says, once we went out with the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam for the janazah of one of the companions amongst the Ansar. And while we were waiting for his burial in the graveyard, in the cemetery, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he started giving us a reminder, and this is one of the evidences that is the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to give a reminder, to give the reminder to the people who are there to bury the deceased so that they can remember their own death. And I would suggest every one of you, next time when you go into the cemetery to bury someone, then before you lower them in the inside the grave, look carefully inside that hole and remember your death and imagine that one day it is going to be your house. It is going to be your place. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he gathered his companions, as Bara bin Azib radiallahu ta'ala says, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam looked up towards the heaven, towards the sky, and then he looked down, and then he looked up, and then down, then looked up, then down, three times, and then he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Ista'idu billahi min adab al-qabr. O my companions, seek refuge with Allah from the punishment of the grave. And he repeated three times. And then he said, Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min adab al-qabr. The Nabi and the Messenger and the best of the creation of Allah, the best of the messengers, the best of the prophets, the best ever human being who have lived on this earth. He says, Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min adab al-qabr. O Allah, I, Muhammad, seek refuge with you from the punishment of the grave. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Then he, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, told his companion, he said, إِذَا كَانَ الْعَبْدُ الْمُؤْمِنُ فِي انْقِطَاعٍ مِنَ الدُّنْيَا وَإِخْبَالٍ مِنَ الْآخِرَةِ نَزَلَ إِلَيْهِ مَلَائِكَةٌ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ بِيضُ الْوُجُوهِ كَأَنَّ وُجُوهَهُمُ الشَّمْسِ. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, when a believer, servant of Allah al-Jalal al-Ikram, is about to leave this dunya and he is heading towards his hereafter, نَزَلَ إِلَيْهِ مَلَائِكَةٌ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ, a group of angels descend and they come down to him from the heavens, and their faces are glowing and so shining, it is as if their faces were the sun. مَعَهُمْ أَكْفَالٌ مِنْ أَكْفَالِ الْجَنَّةِ وَحَنُوطٌ مِنْ حَنُوطِ الْجَنَّةِ, and they bring with them the shrouds and the sheaths of paradise, and they bring with them the fragrance and the scent of the paradise as well. They bring with them the perfume from paradise. And then this group of angels, they stay a bit far away from the believer, and then the angel of death, Malakul Maut, who has been given this duty and responsibility by Allah Dul Jalal Ikram to take the souls away, he comes forward. Hatta yajlisa inda ra'si, until he comes closer to the believer and he sits beside his head. And then he says, أَيَّتُهَا النَّفْسُ الْمُطْمَئِنَّةُ الطَّيِّبَةُ أُخْرُجِي إِلَى مَغْفِرَةٍ مِّنَ اللَّهِ وَرِضْوَانِ. O tranquil and good and pure and good soul, come out, leave this body, come out towards the forgiveness and the pleasure of Allah. إِنَّ رَبَّكِ عَلَيْكِ رَبْ. Indeed, your Lord is happy, is pleased with you. Leave this body. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, فَتَخْرُجُ رُوحُهُ كَمَا تَسِيرُ الْقَطْرَةُ مِنْ فِي السِّقَاءِ. The soul of the believer comes out of his body easily, without any pain, as the drop of the water is, as the drop of the water comes out from the container of the water, without any pain. And as soon as the soul of the believer leaves his body, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, صلى عليه كل ملك بين السماء والأرض وكل ملك في السماء. Every single angel of Allah between the heaven and the earth, and every single angel of Allah in the heavens makes dua for this blessed soul. Look a believer, look the dignity and the honor that Allah has granted you. You do not appreciate the blessing of Iman. Allah Dhul Jalal Ikram has assigned a duty to his angels to pray for you, O believers. Not an ordinary angels, rather the closest angel to Allah Dhul Jalal Ikram. They make dua for you. الَّذِينَ يَحْمِلُونَ الْعَرْشِ وَمَنْ حَوْلَهُ يُسَبِّحُونَ بِحَمْدِ رَبِّهِمْ وَيُؤْمِنُونَ بِهِ وَيَسْتَغْفِرُونَ لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. Those who bear the throne of Allah, those who hold the throne of Allah, they glorify with the praise of their Lord, and they believe in Him, Dhul Jalal wal Ikram, وَيَسْتَغْفِرُونَ لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا, and they seek forgiveness for those who believed in Allah, Dhul Jalal. Those angels above the heavens, they make dua for you. And as soon as the soul of the believer leaves his body, every single angel makes dua for him. And then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, once the angel of death, Malakul Maut, he has taken the soul of the believer in his hands, rest of the angels, they come and they rush towards him and they grab that soul from his hand and they do not leave the soul of the believer in his hand. And they take that soul very quickly away from him. And they wrap it in the shrouds of the paradise. And then they put the perfume of the paradise on that body and shroud. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, so that the best fragrance and the smell comes out from that pure body and soul. And then these angels, they go up, they ascend to the heavens. As they get closer to the heavens, the angels, the gatekeepers of the first heaven, they ask Allah, O Allah, allow this blessed soul to pass through us so that we can welcome this blessed soul. And the angels go up and the gatekeepers of the first heaven, they open the door for him. And then they ask the rest of the angels, Ma hadha ruhu tayyib? What is this pure and good soul? This blessed soul. They say, Yadhkurunahu bi ahsani asma'ihi alladhi kan yudhkaru biha fi dunya. They make the mention of all the good titles and the characteristics that this individual was known with in this dunya. The person who was known as a soft-hearted person, kind, generous, someone whose heart was attached to the house of Allah bil Jalal Ikram, someone who was a regular in his five daily prayers, someone who used to give a lot in the way of Allah bil Jalal Ikram, someone who used to recite the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, someone who loved the book of Allah, someone who loved the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. All the characteristics and the qualities that this individual was known with in this dunya, they make the mention of all those characteristics to the angels in the first heaven. And then yushayyi'uhu muqarribu as-sama'il ula. The angels, the closest to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the first heaven, they accompany their soul and they take the soul to the second heaven. And then from second to third, then fourth, then fifth, then sixth, then seventh, until the soul reaches to the seventh heaven, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Uktubu kitaba abdi fi illijin. Write down the name of my servant in the book illijin. As Allah said in Surah Al-Mutaffifin, Kalla inna kitab al-abrari la fi illijin. Wa ma adraka ma illijin. Indeed, the book, the record of the pious and the righteous is in illijin. What made you to know about illijin? كتاب مرقوم يشهده المقربون. This is a written book, a register, in which the names of the pious and righteous are written. And the closest angels to Allah Dhul Jalal Ikram, they witness that book. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, return the soul of my servant to the earth, because this is what I promised them. مِنْهَا خَلَقْتُهُمْ وَفِيهَا أُعِيدُهُمْ وَمِنْهَا أُخْرِجُهُمْ تَارَةً أُخْرَى. From this earth I created them and I have promised them that they will be returned in this earth and then I will resurrect them, I will bring them up once again from this earth. So let this soul go back and return this soul to the earth. And then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, the soul of the believer is returned into his grave and by then he is buried. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, يَتْبَعُ الْمَيِّتَ ثَلَاثٌ. Three things. Go with the deceased, with the dead body, towards his grave. فَيَرْجِعُ اثْنَانٌ وَيَبْقَى وَاحِدٌ. Two of them, they return. His family, his friends, his relatives, and also his wealth. Everything comes back. ويبقى عمله and his deeds, they remain with him inside his grave. So now the believer is buried in his grave and the life of the grave has begun. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, يَأْتِيهِ مَلَكَانْ, two angels come to him inside his grave. وَجُجْلِسَانِهِ, and they sit him up and then they ask him questions. The first question they ask him, مَنْ رَبُّكْ, who is your Lord? The believer says, رَبِّي اللَّهُ, my Lord is Allah. The one who knew his Lord in this dunya, someone who worshipped Allah alone, without associating any partners with him, ذُلْ جَلَالِ وَالْإِكْرَامِ, he will be able to reply easily, رَبِّي اللَّهُ, my Lord, my Rabb is Allah. And then the angel will ask him the second question, مَا دِينُكْ, what is your religion? He will say, دِينِي الْإِسْلَامِ, my religion Islam, my religion is Islam, because this is the religion that I was proud of. In a positive way, I used to praise Allah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given me such a great and precious gift. Nothing is more important for a believer than his Iman and Islam. O believers and the Muslims, you must thank Allah dhul jalal ikram that Allah has granted you this hidayah and guidance. By Allah, there are billions of people who are deprived from this precious gift of hidayah. And you do not appreciate? You feel embarrassed to be called Muslim amongst your colleagues? Within the company where you work? You feel embarrassed? You must be thankful to Allah that Allah has chosen you to be guided towards His deen. And you must thank Allah Dhul Jalal Ikram, and you must be grateful to Him Dhul Jalal Ikram. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, and the angel asks him the second question, and he replies, Dini al-Islam, my deen, my religion is Islam. And then they asked him the third question, Ma taqul fi hadha ar-rajul alladhi bu'itha feekum, what do you say about that man, about that individual who was sent amongst you as a prophet? And he says, Huwa Rasulullah, he was the messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. These are the common three questions that every one of us know. And we must have heard these questions so many times. Is there going to be any other question? Yes. There can be other questions. The authentic ahadith. So the questions of the grave are not limited to only these three. There can be more questions. As the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said in an authentic hadith, then the angel asked him, Ma amaluk? And some of the narrations say, Ma ilmuk? What was your knowledge and what was your deeds? What were your actions? When it comes to the religion of Allah, because you said your religion was Islam, how much of Islam did you know? What was your knowledge about Islam? And what was your practice of the religion of Islam? You know what is going to be the answer of the believer? The believer will say, قَرَأْتُ كِتَابَ اللَّهِ وَآمَنْتُ بِهِ وَصَدَّقْتُ. My knowledge and my practice was the book of Allah. I used to read the book of Allah and I believed in the book of Allah and I considered the book of Allah to be a true book. I would like to pause here, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam. If there is anyone amongst you who has been making this excuse that I cannot read Quran because I never learned it in my childhood, then ask yourself what is going to be your answer in the grave. When the angel is going to ask you, Ma amaluk, ma ilmuk, would you be able to say, Qaratu kitab Allah, I used to read the book of Allah? You won't be able to lie. Even a non-believer, even a sinner, they won't be able to lie in the grave. If you did not read the book of Allah in this dunya, wallahi, you won't be able to say in the grave, قَرَأْتُ كِتَابَ اللَّهِ. That is why, stop making these excuses, these lame excuses that are not accepted by Allah. If you never learned the book of Allah, it is never late. Even if you have passed 50 and 60 and 70, You still have the time. Allah has given you the opportunity. You have the masajid, alhamdulillah, living in this country, in this society. You have so many halaqas, so many masajid. And Allah is not going to accept your excuse that you did not learn in your childhood, that is why you could not read the Quran. Allah Dhul Jalal Ikram revealed this book for the guidance of all mankind. Not only for Maulana and Imam Sahib and someone who does the dars and the khutbah here, for every one of you. Allah has revealed this book, Allah has sent this message to you, every single one of you. How can you go back to Allah Dhul Jalal Ikram saying this and making this excuse that I could not read? This is not an excuse. So the angel will ask him, what was your practice and what was your knowledge? And he will say, I used to read the book of Allah. And once he is successful in answering the questions in the grave, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say, An sadaqa abdi afrishuhu min al-jannah, albisuhu min al-jannah, waftahu lahu baban ila al-jannah. Allah will say, provide a furnishing to my slave, my servant inside his grave from paradise. And give him the clothing of the paradise. And open a door inside his grave that can lead towards the paradise so that he can smell the fragrance of the paradise and he can get the breeze from paradise. And then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, then the angel shows him his place in the fire. And the angel says, this was your place in the fire if Allah would have not saved you. But Allah has shown his mercy upon you, and Allah has saved you, and Allah has replaced you a house in paradise. Otherwise, if you would have disobeyed Allah, this was your place in the fire. And then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, then the angel, a man with a beautiful face, beautiful clothing comes to him, and that angel appears and comes to him, and as soon as the believer sees his face, he says, your face looks the face of someone who can bring only good news. Man ant, who are you? And that person says, Ana amaluka salih, I am your good deeds. I'm your salah, your zakah, your fasting, your charity, your reading of Quran, your dhikr, your remembrance of Allah, your kindness, your gentleness, your generosity. I'm your good deeds. At that point, the believer gets so excited to the level that he says, Da'uni arji'u ila ahli fa'ubashiruhum. Let me go back to my family and give them glad tidings that I have passed this stage successfully. But the angel says, Uskun nam kanawmatil aus. No, you have to relax. Stay here, relax. Take a rest here and sleep as a newly married bride sleeps. Sleep in your grave. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam says, then the believer says, Rabbi aqim as-sa'a, Rabbi aqim as-sa'a, Rabbi aqim as-sa'a. O Allah, O my Lord, establish the hour. Bring the qiyamah, bring the hour, last hour. Why? Because he knows. Going back to the hadith that I mentioned at the beginning, whoever passes this stage successfully, whatever is going to take place after this is going to be easier. So by then the believer knows that on the day of judgment, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is showing